Hello, my crafty friends. I hope you had a wonderful Christmas time. For today, I have an unboxing video. I got a ton of craft supplies by Dress My Craft, and I just had to show you what's included. If unboxing videos are not your cup of tea, no worries, you can skip it completely. I will come back in the future weeks using these products in some of my projects. So Dress My Craft has amazing crafting products. It's a company from India, and I met the owner, Shalini, when I was in Creativation in USA as well as in Frankfurt for Creative World. These are the two big shows that happen once a year. Well, at least used to happen before COVID. So Shalini, the owner, is super sweet and very generous. She sent me this box of products, and keep in mind that this is not a sponsored video. However, I did get those products for free. I think that this is a great opportunity for you to see the products. They are absolutely amazing, and the quality is perfect. You are able to get them from India, they ship worldwide, or from scrapbook.com, and you will find the links down below for everything you will see in this video. So let's start with one of the collection kits. They do have these collection kits where you can get three products in one pack, but you can definitely get them separately if you want. And if you follow my videos, you have already seen me using products from Dress My Craft for more than a couple of years now. I have been using their confetti, their shaker elements. I have been using their transfer me sheets, which I absolutely love, and their born folders, lots of tools like their scoring board one. But let's focus on what's included in this box today, since you will find some lovely treasures. So this is the Eternal Love collection. You can find a 12x12 pad, the 6x6 pad, as well as those elements that you can cut out. Now keep in mind that this is really thick paper. It's not that thin pattern paper you are used to. It is 240 GSM. It definitely feels like cardstock, and you can easily create your card bases out of this paper. But what's great about this paper pad is that the back of each page is white. So you don't have to fight with yourself on which side to use, plus you get two pages of each design. You will find 24 pages in total. That's 12 different designs. And just because it fits the frame better, I'm going to show you all the designs from browsing through the 6x6 paper pad. Keep in mind that you will get the exact same designs on the 12x12, of course, enlarged. The designs are just lovely. They do have a vintage vibe as well as a shabby chic one. I love that you get some background pages as well as some others that give you little elements to play with. Love that border with the flowers on the right, and I do have an idea on how to use it on an art journal. So an art journal using this collection is coming. And as I browse through the designs, let me let you know a few info that you may find interesting. I did get a box from India, and it arrived in less than 10 days, and that's during the Christmas time, which means that it was super fast, actually faster than what it takes for me to get products from the UK or even from the US. But keep in mind that if you live in the US, you can get everything by Dress My Craft from scrapbook.com. Now, you will also get in the collection these two cardstock papers that you can cut out fuzzy cut elements using your scissors and use them as your focal points. This one is such a pretty collection, absolutely love that one. So let me grab another one that I got in the box, and this one is called Magnolia Hues. Magnolia is one of my favorite flowers. I do have a magnolia tree on my garden. So a big thank you to Shalini for including this collection in my box. Again, this is the collection kit. You get the 12x12, the 6x6, as well as the elements to cut out. And just like all of their collections, it's 240 GSM. Again, acid free, of course. You get 12 designs, two times in each pad, so 24 pages in total. Again, these are not double-sided, and keep in mind that some of these pattern papers in this collection have some foiling. I'm just trying to catch the light for you. Again, here on the side, we do have some foiling, golden foiling in particular. Lovely designs again. Love the color combo. Pastel one with flowers. I think it's the perfect recipe for creating adorable cards that everybody will love. These are the type of pattern papers that you can make cards for pretty much any occasion, and I think I may come back with a video using this collection as a starting point and coming up with many different card designs. Let me know in the comments below your thoughts. And this is where I fell in love with that pattern paper with the door, and I just want to see how big it is on the 12 by 12 one. And it's absolutely amazing. I think it would make a perfect focal point for an art journal page. So I'm going to put that aside and let's grab the papers that you can fuzzy cut to create your focal points. So these are called motifs. I would say they are collage papers. But again, this is thick cardstock. One idea is to add at the back one of those adhesives all over, so that when you fuzzy cut everything, it becomes a sticker instantly. Notice that at the bottom you do get quotes and sentiments to use as well. If you like pattern papers, make sure to check out the rest of their collections, they have beautiful ones. Now of course this company has everything that you can think of when it comes to crafts, so they have every color under the rainbow in cardstock, both in A4 size or for my US friends in letter size or in 12 by 12, and they also have acetate, and I like their acetate because they come in two different thicknesses. This is the thinner one that I'm trying to show you here, and this is perfect for creating shaker cards. You can even easily wrap it around your paper if you want to create infinity shaker cards because it is so thin. Now here is a pack of cardstock that you can use for your card bases or for your die cutting needs. There are many different colors. I just got the pretty cream cardstock here, and I'm going to take it off so that probably you can tell this is not one of those woven ones. It is completely smooth and flat, and it is 250 GSM, which means that it makes a nice sturdy card base. And this is a pack of acetate, which is thicker than the one that you showed previously. This is perfect if you want to create bigger windows and you need that acetate to be nice and sturdy. And it is so thick that you can actually make your card bases out of it if you want to create card bases that are transparent. And I don't know if that detail can help you out, but the thick acetate is 250 microns, while the thinner one is 100 microns. Just an info there in case you want to know. Now here is a product that I never used before and I'm so excited to try it out with you guys. This is the Floral Oriental collection. It is paper, but it is made specifically for creating three-dimensional flowers. You actually die cut the flowers out of it and you dip them in water, and when they dry they become really hard. If you want to see that product in action, let me know in the comments below and I may come up with a card design where I create three-dimensional flowers on top of them using these products. Now of course Dress My Craft do have dies and embossing folders. Here are a few that I got, lovely swirls here, and this one is called Tropical Swirls. Then I have this long border one which is called Ornate Border, and a basic set of dies, 4 in total, that you can use to create your panels for card making. Love that they do give you stitching as well as a scalloped edge. And I also got an embossing folder, and believe it or not, I don't have an embossing folder with text. I think this is really versatile and I can use it for many cards, especially the ones that I make with that vintage look and feel. Absolutely love this one. By the way, let me grab my Dress My Craft die cutting machine so you can see it is super small and handy, especially if you want to create a project without large dies. You can definitely use this one. Now, one of my all-time favorite products by Dress My Craft and products that I keep on using on my art journal projects are the Transfer Me pages. I have demonstrated how to use them and you can look through my channel. You just basically peel them off, stick them on top of your page and just transfer them using water. They have an amazing collection of designs, and here I have the one which is called the Wooden Background number 3, as well as the Vintage Text number 1. Now I was also super surprised to find out that they sent me a scoring board in the box. And this is one of those multi-purpose scoring boards that you can make so many things with them. I will probably make one of those back to basics videos where I can use this scoring board to show you how many different projects you can come up with. At the back you will find that it has foam, so it's not going to scratch your surface and it doesn't slide. But at the back there is also a little pocket where you can store your scoring tool, as well as this triangle thingy that you can use to create many different things. You can use this to create boxes, envelopes, and even thick envelopes to fit your thicker cards. I will make a video to show you how easy it is to work with. Now, I already have the baby one, the baby scoring board. You can see how small it is. I have been using it for a couple of years now. This is my scoring board for creating my cards. I find it's the perfect size for card making. Now, let's take a look at some other fun products that were in the box. And these are shaker mixes, as well as glitters and other fun stuff. So this is your basic chunky glitter in a color that is super versatile. It's called Sparkling Dust. This is a sequin mix and the color is fairy. Purple pastel colors, lovely one. I think that this would match perfectly with the Magnolia collection. We got lots of purple in those papers as well. Then this is a jar with tiny little pearls. This is called flower pearls, and they are perfect for sticking them at the center of your tiny flowers. Here is a close-up look. Probably you can see them better. If you add at the center of your flower some glossy accents on any other type of glue and just stick them there, they will give a great effect. And now let's take a look at the most fun product that they have. These are little jars of shaker mixes in any kind of shapes. So here you can see you get those little watermelons. You can find jars with candies inside or even cupcakes. There is even that black and white one that has little penguins inside. This is a really unique product. Super adorable, perfect if you love creating shaker cards. And I have to say that box was super packed with products. Here are a couple more mixes. This is the copper mix and that's the shabby chic mix. Then in the box I also found a couple of punches. There is this bigger one that helps you punch notches for creating envelopes, and I'm going to show you how to do that in another video. There are also a bunch of other products that help you create the stems as well as the centers of three-dimensional flowers. And if you are into creating three-dimensional flowers, check them out. They have an amazing craft product collection for that. This is florist tape. It's the one that you wrap around the stems. Then I also got this tiny punch. How adorable is this one? I had to open those punches so that you can see exactly what they do. So here is the envelope punch that creates that notch, and on the other side it is a corner rounder. And then the tiny one is also a corner rounder. It just gives you a smaller rounded corner. And this box just keeps on giving. These are floral accessories again for creating the center of your three-dimensional flowers. This is again one of those tools that you can use for adding dimension on your flowers. And you're supposed to use that with that paper that I showed you in the beginning. That flower making specialty paper. This is a stainless steel tool and it has some grooves at the bottom, and you're supposed to use it on top of a soft area, something like a mouse pad would do the trick. Make sure to check their YouTube channel, the Dress My Craft YouTube channel. They have amazing videos on how to use all those flower making crafting supplies. And finally, this is a little box that comes with a pack of six little jars. These are little sprinkles inside in earthy colors. Again, perfect for your shaker cards. And that's the last thing that I'm going to show you from the box. There is one more thing that I'm keeping it a secret because it hasn't been released yet. It's their upcoming collection, which is absolutely adorable. So that's it from me. I hope that the unboxing video was fun for you as it was for me. If you have any ideas on future videos using those products, let me know in the comments below. I will make a note and make sure to use the products. In the description, you will find links on where you can get Dress My Craft products. A big thank you to Shalini for this amazing box. And a big thank you to all of you guys for joining me today.